auto, I guess, trade there is interesting in Hanwha Life. They survey everything. They choose a pick that works with their comp rather than one that can interact very meaningfully with the enemy.
I think the answer might be no. But he's still going to go for it. Does have himself the fear, Keen. Gets inside track as they try to lock down Bono. Gets the knock up. Keen is too damn good on the Aatrox. Hits every button. And now Tal himself has to walk away. In the wings.
He was revealed there, but I'm not sure if it was a vision or not.
I think it might have been a visual bug. As Spirit does have that shield, it means he's not going to get taunted up. The ult comes in. Spirit does die, but not after the mid laner goes down first. Yukal immediately flashing after Bono. He's got this one. It's going to be the double. And Afrika Freaks are well and truly on the board. The Claw of Doom, when will it come back off cooldown? Three members around Yukal right now is Keen. Not going to have an opportunity to get in, and he does pay for it with his life.
A bit more in the summer season. Top side, we're seeing a fight as the Drake is being taken.
Oh, okay, ultimate not going to land, and Tal not going to be able to get in there. Has teleport available here as Spirit does take the dragon, but now can Sungyun find the damage, the taunt, the flash. Yukal does get the ultimate off just in the nick of time, and now Chaos Storm comes through. Proud with a flash, but misses everyone. And the Lissandra eventually falls down. Keen's got himself right into the middle of this team fight, though, has himself the World Ender running, but it's a bad news story for the Afrika Freaks. The health bar's so incredibly low. That was aggressive. Estal has the shield from the Disdain, somehow keeps himself alive, and Hanwha Life Esports. And has picked that one up to evolve.
Gank time.
As Spirit does have himself the shield, but gets Justice punched. Look at the damage, misses it, but that's just to give the kill over to Sungyun. As our Proto Belt doesn't steal it away from
very curious spot.
And now the bot lane pays the price.
Yeah.
No more conscious jungle on stage. You know that your jungler is being trusted to play something that he's practiced. And at the end of the day, if you make good decisions like you did around Drake, you praise those. And if you read the jungle map wrong, you have to criticize those in the mid lane.
Yeah, Proud already used his stand behind beside me, and the Disdain is going to throw him back into the members of Hanwha Life Esports, exactly where they wanted them. Paranoia comes down, but Justice Punch is there to answer. They will get rid of the Galio, but now Keen makes his way into the team fight, wanting to save this Afrika Freaks roster, and is going to do so by taking down
Bono. Great flank teleport from Keen, enters the fight late, cleans it up, and the Infernal Drake and the mid lane turret, while trading up in kills, is what Afrika Freaks pick up, and that actually brings the game into a bit of parity.
Yeah, this will completely even things out.
Is something
worth talking about. Yukal not going to waste any time, flashes immediately, but not going to be able to make enough distance with the Claw of Doom. It's a really nice exhaust to stop him from moving too far, and Lava with the timing on the Justice Punch will pick up Yukal.
We'll
get in there now. He has the opportunity of diving on forward. Does have the paranoia, gets into the pick,
doesn't
steal away the Baron. It's going to be Bono that locks it down. Proud is dead. Spirit immediately dies, and Hanwha Live, they will just jump all over the top. And the Afrika Freaks, they rolled the dice, and it came up double 60.
Exactly. It's all about the gambling and snake eyes for Afrika. No Baron steal. It's close to a 50-50. But Hanwha Live put the faith in. The smite comes down, and so will the structures. That is a big change in fortune for Hanwha Live.
Absolutely.
Thank you, Zero.
Yep. There's not going to be an inner turret there for very much longer, and it's going to go down. Inner's still standing in the mid and bottom side.
It's 50-50. Seems hard to see Hanwha Life not pushing forward and getting at minimum an inhibitor in the next minute or so.
But standing around the mid lane is not going to do that. You're just going to bleed another inner turret. Bottom lane is going to get taken down. It looks like Hanwha Life get the fight that they're looking for. Hanwha should be able to get some agency
his
on this
turn.
One. Flashing forward, Yukal does manage to get the Zhonya's down in time as Keen is sort of free-hitting on this back end, aiming, trying to get the Chaos Storm in a decent position, but Lava grabs that first kill, and now it's just front to back for Hanwha Life Esports. Sungyun having the greatest time ever as this full health Kai'Sa. Keen does get a knock-up, but is it going to be enough? The answer is just a straight-up no. And Hanwha
was asking, they're going to ask the same thing about the Baron. Where is she? Where is she? Well, she's dead. Half a second here. Goodbye, Baron. Goodbye, Afrika Freaks, unless they can find a miraculous team fight to turn around this game.
And remember, this is Afrika Freaks on the blue side with that very creative draft that managed to ban away all of these key picks for Hanwha Life Esports. Not going to be able to even get this Mountain Drake as Lava just bullies them out. You were endorsing bullying yesterday, Papa Smithy, and it's happening again on the Rift today.
Yep, now.
This is the team that got knocked out of Kesper Cup in the first round.
by a team with no coach.
A team with no coach down. Full of...
He has to avoid it because aiming does do a lot of damage, but that has pressured him out of this mid lane.
Lifesteal with the Hurricane, going to be massive anyway, so they can afford to make slight mistakes like that and get away scot-free.
Was it even a mistake? I mean, chunking him out, getting out of there, he calculated that he'd be able to do so. Another wave that is going to be difficult for the Afrika Freaks to defend because Tal just puts his face in front of the turret and takes it down. He's taking no damage at all. And Afrika Freaks are just watching as Harmful Life Esports walk into their house and break all their stuff.
If you learned anything from playing solo queue, if you watch the game around, you can't be surprised if you're watching some LP drop after the game is over. You want to control your own destiny. You want to make the move. They've got a Nocturne. He only goes in. And yet, have we even seen Spirit outside of the point-blank damage ult? Gap close with the ultimate, I guess around a Baron, but that was not
and
even
a lot of that. You have to imagine has to do with the fact that Proud is there on the roster of Spirit. He's been caught out, he's got no mana, and he's dead.
Baron does not spawn just yet. The Elder is a minute 40 away. Inhibitor for Hanwha Life. Then that substitution we were talking about is 100% coming in as Hanwha Life want to get here and break the third inhibitor. And we're going in deep.
Oh, yeah, there's the flash from Bono, the hero's
entrance.
Sung Yun! Come down on top of him. And Sung Yun, that's a little bit too deep. He's going to get taken down. Tal, not going to get too many fears with that one. But Afrika Freaks may have halted them without so much of their DPS available. Man, Sung Yun, that was a do or die, and he definitely died.
Don't ask Sung Yun how many Wheat Bix he eats. He's the whole damn box, Atlas. They want to end the game, even though they don't have their Fed to carry.
Well, the flash from Lava means that they're going to be able to kill the mid laner of the Afrika Freaks, Proud and Keen. The only ones left to try and defend. And Hanwha Life Esports, they still have so many of their players in here. Tal just disdains the gigantic world-ending Aatrox back into the team, and it doesn't even matter.
Doesn't matter if Sung Yun goes in and gives over 1,000 gold bounty when the game ends.